Shiny objects aren't the, it's not the fault of the object itself that we look at it as a shiny object, right? Because the best thing in the world, the best course, the best program, the best opportunity in the world, if you're not committed or if it's not the right fit for you, it's a shiny object. But for somebody else, it's a life-turning event or a life-turning opportunity. So there's nothing wrong with the shiny objects themselves, is how we treat them. And I went from shiny object to shiny object without stopping. And the turning point for me really was that Enron K Day seminar in 2009 in Orlando. And it's because I had been chasing a lot of shiny objects, and I had been using my skill set to a limited extent, because there were things that I would learn. And at that time, I'm sure you remember the mini money sites, where like you would just be an eBay affiliate and you'd create these sites that would aggregate eBay data and you'd drive pay-per-click traffic to it. And when somebody bought something on eBay, you'd get a light, tiny little commission from it, right? And it was an interesting model, but there was a lot of improvement that could have been made. And I did it. I improved it a heck of a lot with technology and automation. And then I created research tools to facilitate the process of even the keyword research and all that stuff. But to me, at that time, it was a shiny object in the sense that it kept me busy and occupied, but I really didn't do it to make money, even though I thought I would or that I wanted to. And the biggest turning point, I had two turning points at that event, was when somebody you know quite well, Steve Gautier, came to me and shook my hand and says, "I got to meet the man who made me $100,000 last year." And I'm like, "What do you mean?" "Well, that little script that you developed for the eBay research that you shared in the forum for free with everybody, that script made me $100,000 last year." And I'm
Gotta
like,
love Steve.
"I'm glad it made somebody some money, because I certainly didn't make me any, right?" It was again because I was tinkering and doing things that I was loving. I was pursuing a passion rather than a business.